Hey, what's going on guys, Sandeep here, and if you want to upgrade to Windows 11 from Windows 10, then I will show you how you can do that. But if you find any kind of ISO file on the internet, then that is not a valid file, because right now Windows 11 is available as insider preview only for the developer channel. So if you find any kind of ISO claiming to be Windows 11, then avoid those kind of ISO because it may contain malware and infect your PC. And also, this is the minimum system requirement to install Windows 11. You must have at least 4 GB of RAM, 64 GB of storage, and you must have a UEFI firmware with secure boot enabled, and BIOS won't work. And also, you need to have this TPM, that is Trusted Platform Module or chip, inside your computer. That is a small chip on your motherboard. And if your motherboard or computer is not so old, then this is a common hardware you must have with your motherboard. And in next video, I will show you how you can find if you have Trusted Platform Module or not. And your graphics card should support DirectX 12. So these are the system requirements in order to install Windows 11. And if your laptop or desktop is not too old, then it should have that TPM chip. And your graphics card should support DirectX 12. Microsoft will launch this tool, system requirement checker tool in coming months. So you can use this tool when it is available. I will link it in the video description as well. Okay, now if you want to get Windows 11, then you have to join the Insider program by Microsoft. Go to Start and then Settings. Then go to Update and Security option. And you have to find this Windows Insider program at the bottom. Click on it and you should see this screen, Windows Insider program. To join the Windows Insider program, you have to allow your computer to send diagnostic and feedback data to Microsoft. So you have to enable optional diagnostic data. You can go to privacy setting and enable it, or you can click on this option and it will take you to that setting. By default, it is required diagnostic data. You need to change it to optional diagnostic data. Then enable all these options. Improve inking and typing, trailer experience, view diagnostic data. All these options should be turned on. Now let's go back to Windows Insider program. Click on the Get Started option button. Now Microsoft will ask you to link your Microsoft account. So you must have a Microsoft account. Now select Microsoft account, put your ID and password and click on continue. And after that, Microsoft will link your computer to Windows Insider program. And after that, you will see this screen, choose your Insider settings. There are three options: developer channel, beta channel, release preview channel. Right now, Windows 11 is available for developer channel only. In coming months, it will be available to beta channel and it will be available on release preview channel just few days before official consumer release. So if you want to install Windows 11 right now, then you have to select developer channel. In developer channel, Windows 11 would be less stable. You will get all the new codes first. And in the beta channel is more stable kind of thing. And release preview channel is just actual release preview version that what is consumers are going to get. So you have to select developer channel and click on confirm. And click on confirm again. Now it will ask you to restart Windows. Click on restart. And Windows 10 will install some updates during restart. And after that, you have to go to settings again. After the restart, go to settings, update and security, and check for the latest updates. Now you may or may not see Windows 11 on this update page, but if you are getting other updates of Windows 10, then you have to install, download and install those updates first. And after that, restart your Windows and check for the updates again. So I tried to download this Windows 10 version 21H1, but it didn't go through. But I checked for the update again and I can see that Windows 11 Insider Preview is downloading. So you have to check for the update few times if you are not getting that Windows 11 Insider Preview on the update page. So you have to try it for a few times, and after that it will download Windows 11 and install it. And when it asks you to restart, then click on restart now, and Windows 10 should restart, and you would see this update or underway screen for a long time. So you have to wait for that. And after the update, you should see this kind of screen, that is Windows 11 is installing. Basically, you have to wait till it download and install Windows 11 on your PC. And it may take a lot of time. It took me around 1 hour to completely download and install Windows 11. And you can see that I have upgraded to Windows 11 from Windows 10 without any problem. And also my Windows 10 was not activated because I am using this virtual machine, so I didn't activate that. But you can see that I have successfully upgraded to Windows 11 from non-activated Windows 10. So you can do that as well. So if you want to upgrade to Windows 11, then in short, you have to join Windows Insider program, link your Microsoft account and join the developer channel. And after that, you have to restart your Windows PC, then check for update, let it download and install Windows 11 updates. Then you have to just wait. And after that, you would be able to see Windows 11. And also I can see that UI has been changed in this build of Windows 11. Earlier, I have tested that leaked version of Windows 11, but I can see this version is different. This build is different. I will check it, test it and create some videos. And that's all for this video, guys. Hope this helped. If so, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. Also press the bell icon to get notified about new videos. And I will see you in my next video.